Hi friends, I hope you're doing well. So, there's one thing that a lot of successful developers have in common. Dan Abramov, the godfather of React, Kent C. Dodds, Flavio Copes, these are all examples. Yep, that's right, they all have a blog. So in today's video, I'm going to be talking about why you need a blog too, what to write about, and how to actually start one. Okay, so the first reason why you need to have a blog is because writing helps you to think more clearly. When you write about technical concepts, sometimes you might find loopholes in your understanding. Thinking about how to articulate the concepts forces you to think more critically about it and also strengthens your mental models of the concepts. For example, when I was learning about JavaScript array functions, I was writing notes and I was going through examples, so I thought I had everything all figured out. But it wasn't actually until I sat down and started writing this blog post that I realized, hey, there's actually some little nuances and some little gaps in my knowledge that I didn't realize I had. Until this day, I still find myself coming back to this blog post because everything is laid out so clearly. So yes, writing definitely helps. The second reason why you need to have a blog post is because it's a great way to share knowledge. Teaching is the best way to learn new things, and you don't know who you may be able to help by writing these blog posts. I remember when I first started blogging, I had some people from the business department at work tell me that they actually found my technical blog posts really helpful, and I thought it was really heartwarming because I didn't think that they would be interested in technical concepts because they're working in the business team, but I was wrong. They wanted to upskill and learn about technical stuff, so there you go, and I couldn't be any happier. And the last reason why you need to have a blog is because it acts as a serendipity vehicle. Now, serendipity vehicle is a term coined by David Perel and made popular by productivity YouTuber Ali Abdal. So what actually is a serendipity vehicle? A serendipity vehicle is basically something of yours that you put out that attracts serendipitous encounters to happen. Now, a blog is a serendipity vehicle because anyone on the internet can stumble upon it and discover about you. If they resonate with what you're writing about, serendipitous encounters can happen. You might make a new internet friend that may turn into a business partner, you could get scouted for a job, you could inspire somebody to start a new blog, you could make somebody's day. The opportunities are endless. Now, this is a concept that really fascinates me, and I personally have a lot of experience with it as well. So back when I was in uni, I did a lot of competitions, events, and in my final year, I started creating content. This YouTube channel, and the year after when I started working, I started my blog. So all this work that I had put out eventually created a name for myself, and people started reaching out to me because they were interested in what I was doing and what I was creating. And this is essentially personal branding in a nutshell. Personal branding isn't about creating a fake persona. It's about putting your most authentic self out there and allowing your people to come and find you. Okay, so now you're convinced that you actually need to have a blog, but what do you even write about? Well, you can write about anything really. You can write about what you're learning at the moment, any takeaways you have from a conference or a talk, any lessons you have, and you can also write about your opinions and thoughts on certain things because these do matter. With all these blog post ideas, it can get a little bit overwhelming, so I personally use Scrintal to organize my ideas. Scrintal is an app that combines visual and linear note-taking. It's a visual space that helps you to transform abstract thoughts into concrete ideas and strategies. You can use it for brainstorming, organizing your reading notes, planning your projects, and even as a place for you to organize your daily notes and tasks. Now here is my board where I planned this blog post on JavaScript variables and value types. With this infinite canvas view, it creates an overview which allows me to visualize all my ideas at once. I added tags to the title so that I can easily categorize this blog post. And here I can find a list of all my tags. To capture an idea, I made a card like this, and then made links with other cards to create connections. The really cool thing about Scrintal is that I can actually insert a code block in here, which is really handy for technical blog posts. And even if I don't know the structure of a blog post yet, but I have a bunch of ideas, I can capture them all on Scrintal like this. If I want to focus on a card, I can simply resize it or expand it so that it turns into a page. Notice how in the cards I can embed media like images and also videos. Also, with Scrintal's bidirectional links, I can visually and textually connect ideas, forming a network of interconnected thoughts. Now, the really cool thing about Scrintal is its archiving system. As you can see from the sidebar, I can see a collection of all my cards, boards, tags, tasks, and web links. And if you need something more specific, you can utilize the search function. Scrintal is browser-based, meaning you can access it across your devices, be it a phone, tablet, or a laptop. One thing that will be really cool to see Scrintal add though is something similar to the graph view in Obsidian, because then you can see how, you know, it's relate to each other and give you new ideas. So yeah, with Scrintal's powerful features, gone are the days of juggling between tools for ideation, documentation, and sharing, eliminating the need for context switching altogether. If you're interested in trying Scrintal, you can use my discount code Magdalene for 10% off Scrintal Personal Pro. Do note though that this code is only valid for 4 weeks after the video is out, so do be quick. You can also click on my sign up link in the descriptions and this will automatically apply the discount code for you. Thank you so much to Scrintal for sponsoring this portion of the video. Okay, so now comes the fun bit, time to actually start creating your blog. There are many different platforms you can use to create a blog, such as Medium, Dev.2, Hashnode, etc. But today, I'm going to show you how you can quickly spin up your own site using Hugo, a static site generator. Static site generators like Hugo are really easy for quickly spinning up a personal blog where you just want a place to share your thoughts without having to mess around with styling and the like. So this is my blog that I've created using Hugo. I'm using this really clean and minimalistic theme called Paper Mod, and if I click into your post, you can see that this is how the layout looks like. It automatically generates a table of contents for you, which is really handy, and you can also click into it, and it'll just take you to the respective place. And I've also integrated Discus into my blog so that people can leave comments. In the archive section, you can see a list of all my blog posts in chronological order, and yes, I have not been blogging in a while, so time to get back into it. And then you've got all these tags here, you can search for stuff, and then this is the changelog, basically just a place for me to list on what I've done, what I need to do next, and what I want to do in the future. So yeah, this is my blog. Oh, and then you can also change the theme to dark mode, which is cool, and then I've just got all my links here to my GitHub, my YouTube, my Twitter, and to my links page. Okay, so now comes the fun bit. Time to actually start creating our blog. So first of all, we need to install Hugo. I've got Homebrew installed on my Mac, so I'm just gonna do brew install Hugo. And this is gonna install Hugo. Okay, so now that you've got Hugo installed, we can finally create our blog. And you do it by running this command, Hugo new site, and then the name of your blog, and I'm just gonna call it blog. Okay, nice. Now we wanna follow the instructions. It says change the current directory to blog. So I'm gonna cd into blog, and then I'm going to install a theme. So how I do that is I will create a new Git repository, and then I will add the paper mod theme. Now the third step says edit hugo.toml, setting the theme property to the theme name, so I'm going to do just that. And before that, I'm actually just going to open folder. Yes. And run a new terminal. Okay, so I'm going to go into hugo.toml. And I will add my theme, which is paper mod. Now I will start the server with Hugo server. Okay, so it says that the web server is available at localhost 1313, so I'm gonna go there. So this is what I see so far. It's quite different to my blog because we've got a few settings that we need to add to the hugo.toml file. Okay, so now we're going to add the settings to this file. Now don't worry about copying all these because I'm going to publish this repository later. Okay, so now let's see how our blog looks like. Okay, it's looking a lot better than before. We can see that we've got the heading over here and then the subheading. But these pages are still not working. And we don't have our post yet. So just to explain how this hugo.toml file works, it's basically a file that contains all the global settings for your blog. So for example, if we look at this, params.home info params, this is what controls this text over here. So if I change this your name, to Magdalene, now going to say, "Hello world, I'm Magdalene," so you can easily customize it. And then as for this part, params, social icons, it's these icons over here. So you can change the URL to whatever URL you want. And then lastly, this menu.main is what creates these three tabs at the top. But if I click into it, it's not working because we don't have the files created yet. But you can see that the URL is correct. It's pointing to the page, but the page doesn't exist yet. Okay, so why don't we do that? Let's create the archive page and the search page. So to do that, we're gonna go into content and add a new file, archive.md. And we're gonna give it these settings. So basically what this, so it's a markdown file, which means you can write markdown stuff inside here. But what these opening pluses and closing pluses mean is that we are injecting TOML into this markdown file. So if we look at our blog now, we can see the archive finally has a title. And we're gonna create a search.md and again paste in these details. So now if we go to search, now we can actually see a search box and no longer the 404 page. Okay, so now that we've got the basic structure of our blog up and running, we can write our first post. So I'm gonna create a new terminal to keep this running. And I'm gonna create a new post with Hugo, new content, posts, my first post.md. So you can see that it's being created in this content folder posts, and it's over here. And these settings have been automatically generated, including the date. And down here you can start writing your content. So I'm gonna write this. So basically from this part onwards, it's all marked down. Okay, so now to see our post, we're gonna do Hugo server dash dash build drafts. And now we can see our post over here. Nice. This table of contents has been automatically generated because we've got this H2 heading over here. And here you can see a preview of the post. Now you'll notice this little icon here, and this basically indicates that it's a draft post. So once you're ready for it to be published, you can change the draft to false, and that will remove the icon. So now it's gone. Now as with our hugo.toml file, there are more things that you can add to the toml settings. So we can add these over here. So now that I've got my first post, if we go to archive, we can see that our first post is here. And you can see that I've added a tag here called first. And in order to get that showing, I need to go Hugo server again. And now if we go to this, you can see the first tag is there. Go to tags, we'll see tags up here, which is great. So yep, that's pretty much how you can get a blog up and running on Hugo. And as for hosting, I host mine on GitHub Pages and I bought a domain name for it, just Magdalene Huang.
So yeah, I hope this video inspired you to create a blog and that you now know how to actually start one.
If you're interested in trying Scrintal to help with your thought process, don't forget that you can use my discount code Magdalene for 10% off Scrintal Personal Pro. Do note that this code is only valid for 4 weeks after the video is out though, so do be quick. You can also click on my sign up link in the descriptions and this will automatically apply the discount code for you.
If you do end up creating a blog, then please leave the link in the comments down below so that we can all check it out and support each other. If you like this video or found it helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more content like this. Stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!